We're going to be measuring the range of motion for right elbow flexion. So to begin, we need to know a few things as far as landmarks go. The lateral aspect of the acromion, or the center of the acromion process. The lateral epicondyle of the humerus, and the styloid process of the radius. To begin, we'll place the patient in the testing position that we've already asked our patient to do so. Supine, the arm abducted, within 0 degrees of abduction. Then we'll go ahead and move the patient through the available range of motion. We'll make a visual estimate as long as determining the end feel, which is soft. The visual estimate looks to be 140 or so. We'll return the patient back to the starting position, at which point we can palpate those anatomical landmarks that we mentioned earlier. We can align the goniometer with the fulcrum, again over the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. The proximal arm aligned with the lateral aspect of the humerus. We use the acromion as a reference. And then the lateral aspect of the radius using the styloid process of the radius. We'll read and record the starting position. It's close to zero, a couple of degrees. Remove the goniometer and then perform passive range of motion, keeping the forearm supinated. We'll replace the goniometer with the fulcrum in the same landmark. Proximal arm, same landmark. And distal arm in the same landmark. And we have about 140. And we'll read and record that. And that's range of motion, the measurement of range of motion. Right arm flexion.